Hey guys, welcome back. I hope every one of you are safe and healthy. So I'm back to explain the breakdown structure of an API. So let's check like how to generate a mock API and try to hit it using Postman today, and we'll understand like the breakdown structure of that API too that we create. For this I have used the mockaroo.com. It helped me a lot. So anybody who is practicing can create your own schema and an API out of this. It's just a minute process. So I clicked on the create schema, and these are the fields that mockaroo actually suggested me, so I can add, delete any number of fields that I want. And let me give a 10 row count, and then I say save this schema. This is a demo purpose, so let me name it a demo. So I saved my demo schema. This is the first step, and then the second step is to create an API out of this schema. So once I saved it, you see an option here to create an API. Just hit that, and then you see the demo.json. Now I say create API. So you see API got created. So very simple step. So you can create number of mock APIs, and you test it in any automation that you want to practice. So let me copy this into, this is the endpoint or the URL that I want to hit. So I will copy it here. Okay, I need, let me increase my font size. Okay, all right, this is my URL or the endpoint that I got. So if you see this carefully, right, HTTPS is the protocol that we are using, either based on the security protocol imposed on the API. It can be either HTTPS or a HTTP. Anything after that, like myapi.mockaroo.com, is called the domain name or the server name that we are accessing. So this is the domain that we are hitting, and the demo.json is the method that got generated out of that schema in the earlier step, right? So this is the method name. So the question mark indicates the queries. So anything after the question mark are called the query parameters. In this case, we have only one query parameter, which is key, and it is having a value of B667BF30 that we are sending to the server. So using this query parameter, we are, and this method, we are trying to hit this particular server or domain and get some information. Now all the world of APIs run in request and responses, right? So you are sending some information or some of these query parameters to the server and getting some information back from the server. Let me quickly tell you this, show you this in the Postman API using Postman. So let me create one new collection here. So okay, I have an option directly to create a collection. Okay, I call it demo one because I already have a demo, and create. So collection, you can think of collection as a package. It contains of number of requests. Now how you bundle those requests is up to you. Like for example, I bundle it based on my application. I've seen some of them bundling them based on the type of request, like, you know, all gets at one place, all posts at one place, like that. There are number of types of requests, right? Get, put, post, etc. So based on how what level of ease you want, you can just you know, organize this collection. And once I created my collection, I add one request here using the add request option. So I'm demoing it. Demo get is my request name, for example, and I'm saving it to this collection. Now I have a dummy get request. I don't have any URL here. The URL, I'm pasting this URL that we just got in that mockaroo.com. And then if you check this, right, the moment I pasted it, you see the key value here. This is the query parameter that got in. If you have more query parameter, for example, key 2 is equal to ABCD something, right? And then okay, you see the query parameter. Oh, I'm sorry, it's not dollar, it's ampersand. So ampersand is the second. So any number of query parameters you give, they get added here. So I'm just this removing this, as we don't have that. We only have one query parameter, and I'm sending it to the server. Ta-da, you see the response back. Now once we get the response back, our immediate attention should be the status code. Status code 200 says that all okay, you got the response back from server. And now validating content of what we are getting back from the server is the second step. But straight away my eye has to go here, and then I always see the time, the response time. So it took 366 milliseconds in this case to hit the server and get the response back from the server. So this is what I wanted to share with you. So you got the breakdown structure of what API that we just got generated out of that Mockru. So the protocol, and then follows the server and the method name, and then the query parameters. And we use that request or URL, and we tried using it in Postman, and we saw the response back. So this is how I use Postman and create collections. And one best advantage of the collection is, let me show you, can always, you know, if you have like 10 to 15 requests in this collection, you can use this export option and share as a collection itself. You need not have to send individual requests to anybody within the team. So using this export, I use a lot. So it's very handy. So this is how a request will be sent. And I hope you guys got an understanding of the breakdown structure of the URL. So if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to post in the comment section, and I'll get back to you all soon. Again, stay safe and healthy, guys. Happy testing. Enjoy what you're doing. I'll talk to you all soon in the next session. Bye-bye.